Hi, this is Ryan Bausch and Caleb Anderson from DCIQ The Martial Arts. Today we're going to talk to you about a kick called Yoko Geri. It's a side kick. We're going to demonstrate it for you a couple of times, and then we're going to break it down so you can see all the mechanics behind it to make sure you can all practice it correctly and safely. Here we go. So I'm going to have Caleb start. He's going to give me a couple of Yoko Geri kicks. You can watch his feet, watch his posture, and then we'll break it down for you guys. Go ahead, Caleb. Excellent. One more, please. Perfect. Great. So we're going to have Caleb do a couple more kicks, but I'll point to the parts that I want you to pay the most attention to. We're starting down here all the way at his foot. Pivoting on the ball of your foot is very important. It protects your knee joint. So we're just going to have Caleb pivot here so you can watch what happens to his foot right there. Go ahead, Caleb. Excellent. So that heel comes off the ground, and we're putting all the weight there. And this takes tension off the knee so that we're not forcing the knee joint to move in any way that's unnatural. We're keeping pressure off it so that it's a nice, clean, efficient pivot. Right? Notice that leg will come up. It's called chambering when Caleb turns, pivots, and brings that knee up to his stomach. The other chamber, we're getting ready for that kick. We're holding it for maybe half a second before we're ready to let it go. And then, of course, through chambering, we unleash the leg for that final side kick. Toes aren't straight up. That's a different kick. It's my Geri. Toes are going to be to the side, which in fact gives us the Yoko Geri kick. So a couple more big ones, Caleb. Good. Toes to the side. You can kick high, you can kick to the midsection, or you can kick low. Up to you, depending on where your target is. So, Yoko Geri and its completion. Please practice as much as you can. Review the video. Make sure to watch your knees and enjoy.